Before I demonstrate what we're going to be doing, I want to give a brief explanation of what our expectations are around doorways. First and foremost, what I'm looking for the dog is, in general, what I call politeness. And what I mean by that more specifically is I don't want the dog being pushy, and it makes it a lot easier if I also request that the dog stays in a sit position while I open the door. What I mean by not being pushy is I don't want the dog crowding my space. So I like to have a little bit of breathing room around a door. So if I'm trying to open this door and I have a dog kind of in between me and the doorway, I find that to be a little bit rude. It would be no different than if I were coming to your home and you were trying to unlock your front door. And while you're trying to do that, I'm trying to push you out of the way so I can get in first, right? You would think that I was a pretty impolite human being if I did that. And so since we don't generally allow it from other people, we should try and create the same expectation from our dogs. So really what I'm looking for is that my dog gives me a little bit of room. I like him to be slightly behind me, and then I want him to be holding a sit position. And ideally, they're not, you know, in that sort of drivey, pushy state of mind. If they are, we can just wait them out a little bit until they settle. One of the other key elements of this is once my dog is sitting, I want to make sure that my leash is nice and loose so I'm not holding them in position. And think back to when we first started the heel exercise, that we want at least that metal part of the leash coming down before the rest of the leash comes up to you. And you know, we always have a saying that restraining is not training. So if the leash is straight, the dog knows that you're kind of holding them in position and they don't have any choices. And so they're not really using any self-discipline. We want the dog to feel that they are free to move, but we've established a rule and they're abiding by that rule. The next thing that's important is that we want to make sure that once they're in that sit position, that we open the door and that the door opening in and of itself does not trigger them to get up and move. And so normally, if I'm walking through a doorway on my own without a dog, I sort of open the door and move through it in all one fluid motion. But when I'm practicing with a dog, I always want to be testing them a little bit. And here, what I'm trying to do is test the dog to make sure that they're being patient and that they're waiting for my cue to walk through. So every time I'm going through a doorway with a dog, I get the dog in that nice, polite position where they're sitting. I open the door, but I don't move my feet, and I pause for a second to make sure the dog's being patient. As long as they're continuing to be patient, then I can walk through the doorway, and me walking through is their cue that they are allowed to follow. So a couple of things may happen within that practice. So one is, if when I go to reach for the door or when I actually open the door, my dog might start to come up out of that sit position. And if that happens, all you're gonna do is simply say no or nope. And it doesn't have to be a very harsh tone, but just nope. And then add a little bit of that same upward leash pressure that we've already conditioned our dogs to understand. And we're gonna hold the pressure until they go back into a sit position, and then a nice active release. And we can do that as many times as we need to. While I'm doing that, I will also close the door again and sort of reset myself. And then once they're sitting, I'll try again. And again, it doesn't matter if it takes 10 or 12 repetitions, I'll continue to do it until I can open that door fully without my dog passing through. Another thing that may happen is when your dog gets up, they might have been a little bit quick and now they're a little bit in front of you. And you might find that your space is a little bit congested. I find it can be very difficult and sometimes stressful for the dog if we just try and pull them back out of our space. So if you do find that in one of those repetitions, your dog starts crowding you a bit, what I would recommend that you do is actually just make a quick loop around and reset your position. It's going to be a lot easier on you and a lot less stressful on your dog. Now, once you've gotten that part good and the door is open and your dog's waiting patiently, the next step is that you take a step through and your dog has to follow. Ideally, the dog follows politely in that nice heel position that we've already started to teach. However, if when you open the door and start to walk through, your dog tries to bolt through, again, don't try and get really, really forceful there. Give a light correction to stop them and then come back in, reset yourself, and do the whole thing again. So what you're going to want to do is make sure that your dog doesn't actually get through the doorway until they do it properly start to finish. The big mistake that I see people making there is if when they are walking through, their dog gets that that little surge of energy and tries to bolt through, they correct the dog, but then they continue to go through and then continue to go on their walk. We really want our dogs practicing doing this the proper way from start to finish. So if on the way through the doorway, your dog gets a little bit intense or crazy, or you lose control a little, no worries, just come right back in, reset everything, and make sure you do it again, start to finish, and your dog learns to do it politely. Taking the time to do this now is gonna pay off big time later on. So if in these early repetitions of practicing walking, if you only have a 15 minute window to practice and it takes you 12 out of those 15 minutes just to get through the doorway properly, I fully support that. Because if you do it now and your dog knows that you're gonna be extremely patient, next time or later on, it's only gonna take you 2 seconds. And if you let the dog be a little bit pushy about it now, and you sort of bend your rules now, you're gonna be fighting it every single time. And so cumulatively, you're gonna spend a lot more training time on this exercise if you don't address it early on. So really take the time to do it now, even if that means you're putting off the training of actually walking the dog.